So I have a Pentair Prowler Crawler 920. 930 is the same. They're the same thing. Does a great job. You can see it doing it still. We had a bad windstorm last night. Put a bunch of dirt in my pool. Yes, I have a cover. But I wanted to show you something that I did for mine that has saved me probably three different times from having to replace a part on it. I made a holder for the controller. So yours will have this same push button pad on here, and it's, you can see it's the Matronix Advanced 115. You've got the same, it's the same for the 920, the same for the 930 controller. But what I did is I took a 5-gallon bucket and I drilled a hole here and a hole on the other side so it could drain any water that got in there. And then I put a larger hole to get the extension cords in and out of it. I just put a little bit of gravel, some rocks I had in there, and there's actually a leftover piece of my coping stone. And I put that inside of there, and then I put this lid on top of it. And the beauty of this is, and yes, that's connected to a GFI outlet, so it's not really a concern of getting electrocuted, although I could put that into the extension cord in the bucket. But somebody doesn't come kick my controller. It's heavy enough, it doesn't get knocked in the pool. Gee, why would I do that? Well, I had one get knocked in the pool and fried a couple $100 controller, and I thought, nope, not going to happen again. The other thing I like about this is I put this opaque lid on there, and from my house, I can at night see the glow that this is actually operating. If it's not, I've lost power for some reason. Maybe the GFI has tripped, or it's just ran its one cycle, and you can see it's doing its thing. It runs for a couple of hours. I can't remember what the amount was on there. It runs for a couple of hours, does its thing. But great unit. I really like it. I like it almost better than the vacuum ones because it doesn't pull all of this stuff into your filters in your main unit there. It's got some drawbacks. The cord is 50 feet long, which is just long enough to not hit my deep end with the cover open, or with the cover closed. I have to open the cover up and move the controller halfway down. But overall, I really like it. But this has saved me two different times from that getting pulled in that I know of, and I'm sure it's saved me more than that. Real simple, real easy solution, and keeps it waterproof. Because it's not the controller. If you soak that controller, it will get zapped. My neighbor ruined his. I ruined one. I talked to another guy that ruined one. Took a 5-gallon bucket, cost me $3 at Home Depot. Drilled it in there, put an opaque lid on it. I wasn't $5 into the whole thing. Grabbed a leftover piece of coping stone that I put the controller on top of so that if water got inside of it, it would drain out of those sides before it ever got up to my controller. And it saved me. Hopefully it saves you as well, but it saved me from having to replace that and a couple hundred bucks.